What is happening? Nick Pollack here with another pitch video breakdown, and this is an exciting one. This is Shohei Ohtani. He did an amazing thing yesterday against the Astros. 12 strikeouts, almost through a perfecto, almost. It was kind of nuts. And I think in honor of it, and we might be doing this a little later on, let me know what you guys think. We're probably going to do these massive start breakdowns and then try and cut them down into about a 10-minute video. But today, I'm going to do the entire thing just straight. I wore my Ohtani shirt. And by the way, if you don't know who I am, I run a site called PitcherList.com. I was a former pitching coach, college baseball coach, all that fun stuff. I am live every morning, 9 a.m. to 11 a.m., sometimes 12. So come to twitch.tv/PitcherList, talk about everything you want, and leave in the comments below who you want me to talk about next. But we're going to do all of this from Shohei Ohtani because it was just so good. It was so good, and you got to understand why, and I'm going to talk about it through. I'm not even going to tell you everything now. We're just going to watch. So he starts off the game. And he overthrows a fastball, okay? And that's actually kind of a thing to keep in mind through this entire outing is about that fastball. It's 95 down. I don't know what he's swinging at, Pena. That's a fastball down here that you shouldn't be swinging at. You normally don't get low whiffs on fastballs. That's pretty obvious out of the hand that it's not a strike, but all right. And there's the slider at 82. And this thing is glorious. And I want to emphasize that I have my lovely colors, okay? The slider, especially from a righty to a righty, is trying to come down over here. When it's early in counts, this is 1-1, right? This isn't like an 0-2 pitch. You're just trying to get one for a strike. After two fastballs, you are going to just try to be throwing it anywhere around here, essentially. You just don't want it up like this, because then Pena can lean out and go the other way. But for the most part, you're going to be seeing from a righty to a righty, you're going to be seeing sliders that come around here and sometimes like that, okay? That's generally the goal of it. This is fine. You're just trying to throw for a strike right now at 1-1. It's pretty cool. So, good stuff there. And you're going to see this emphasis of sliders this entire game, okay? Ohtani really shifted in this one to throw more sliders. I expect another 1-2, exactly what we were talking about before. And there it is. That is that area that we're talking about right here. That's it. Get off the plate. And the lateral movement of this pitch is so insane. Look at this. One more time. Full speed. Oh, that's the other one. Get out of here. Full speed here. Oh, my God. That thing starts like here and goes all the way off. That's insane. Also, Ohtani started that at bat with two fastballs down. And he's thinking about that as he goes. Okay, first pitch to a lefty. What is in the arsenal of Ohtani? He has that slider. He also, let's see if I get my numbers right. Let's go with this color. There we go. He also has a first pitch curveball, which he's trying to do. It's probably throw around here, but honestly, you can float it up in here. That's fine. As long as it isn't like, I mean, really, as long as it's not just like here for Brantley, just kind of jump and pull. But honestly, if you throw it anywhere in the zone, he shouldn't really get a swing, right? It should be free realistic. We'll see what he throws. No, he threw a 96 mile per hour fastball. And I will say this, that is a strike. We know this. We see the box. We get it. But Ohtani isn't trying to throw it here. He's trying to throw it over here. You know, with your fastballs, you're trying to go about down and in and up. Sorry, down and up. Down and away. And up and in. These are the places you're trying to go with fastballs. Generally, you don't want to go here or here. This is generally the danger zone for a lefty. This is where you can sneak things in because they want to hit it here, right? So that's not ideal. And he didn't get a strike, but he didn't deserve one because his command is off. So now that you have that, do you pepper the one you're trying to do? Oh, he's trying to do a backdoor slider, and there's so much movement there. Just doesn't it come far enough back. 2-2. He peppers in the 96 he was trying to do with the first pitch. Okay. Brantley, honestly, I mean, I'm sure Brantley was looking for something over here as opposed to down there. So he took that one. Now 2-1. Try and do that backdoor slider again, right? Let's see. Oh, that's so gorgeous. This is such a perfect pitch. Oh, my God. This is 2-1. Right? If you're Brantley, if Michael Brantley here just saw a fastball right here, okay? In this location, down and away. At 2-1, he's hoping to see another fastball that kind of leaks out over here so they can drive it and get a base hit. if you're going to throw a slider, you don't want this. Generally, when it comes to a righty-lefty slider, it's hard to do effectively. Why? Because the ball is going into the bat of the swing. It's going toward Brantley at a slower speed, which is generally easy to wrap around and hit to right field. That's why generally when you throw sliders to right-handers, left-handers as a righty, you're going to throw it down here because you're trying to take advantage of that fact that they are hoping to hit it here, and then it goes underneath it, and you can't hit it. But it's really hard to tell because it travels all the way across. If you're going to throw it for a strike, though, you have to get it away. You have to get it over here, okay? Because if it comes back into this, then it's going to be tugged and pulled and everything like that. At 2-1, if Brantley is looking for a slower pitch, then he would jump on that slider. And what's so good about this one from Ohtani is how long it stays off the plate. I'm going to do this one slowly here. Out of the hand, this pitch is other batter's box, and it stays there. And it's still there. It's still there. It's still there. It's still there. It, only into the last moment does it come back over the plate. I mean, this is such a perfect 2-1 pitch for someone like Brantley that would jump on it. Oh, and you've earned whatever you want now. You want to throw a splitter? You want to throw a high fastball? Like, whatever you want, Ohtani. There's a splitter. Yep. Oh, my God. He broke his bat. Oh, my God. Oh, man. So, Brantley doesn't swing at the two strikes that he gets, which is a fastball here and a slider over the plate. And he's so frustrated at the slider call. And he breaks his bat. You see the piece fall off. You can see Ohtani look at it and go, whoa. Okay. He stopped. Look at that. Yeah, that's what you do to people, Ohtani. All right, so now you got 9 pitches in. You go against Alex Bregman. First real estate. Oh, look. You threw a fastball inside here. This is fine. First pitch heater inside corner. Bregman was aggressive. Jams him a little bit because I believe this is just skied. Yeah, and this is an out. This is now to left. Easy. Done. Cool. You threw a strike inside corner. You're not trying to, or inside edge, I should say, because it wasn't really the corner. You're not trying to do too much with that. It's just a first pitch strike. Better that it was up as opposed to, or middle rather, than it was down. That's the only time you want YM lock, which is a vertical middle location. You want like this is better than this. Because this is an easier bat travel. Like, drop the bat, and that's where the barrel is. But if you drop the bat here, the barrel's over here, and that's where the ball is, so it means you get jammed. Wonderful art. I know. I love the new colors, guys. I'm digging it. Okay. All right, so Ohtani peppers 98 down away. Woo! Yeah, that's happy Ohtani. That's happy Ohtani. That's so good. If you can do that every time, you're fine. As you saw against Alvarez, like, he tugged it early on against the lefty before in Brantley. Now I want to see that free real estate of the slider coming back over. Oh, and he did that harder one. You know, Ohtani has like that 84 mile per hour slider. He also has the 89 mile per hour cutter, you could say. He messes around with them. He's trying to do this backdoor. Excuse me. He's trying to do a backdoor. Alvarez, this was a good one to swing at, man. I think he thought it would be the slider that falls off farther. And it didn't, right? It stayed up at 89. And that's hard to do as a batter. That's hard to figure out what's coming there. So you can play off of this. Excuse me. You can throw the slider now down here, right? You can, let's see. Let's get the right color. Yeah, you can throw the slider into the danger zone now because you can pair it with that cutter. So he thinks it's the cutter again, and it's not. He doesn't know how far the slider will go. Let's see what we get. So he threw the splitter again. And the splitter, what he's trying to do every time, I mean, you guys probably know this, he's trying to keep it down there. You do not want to see a splitter up here. You want to see it in this area. As you can clearly see, it seems super low, and he still swung. Because the heater, where did it go? It started here. It started along this line. And that splitter, if you watch this again, is going to start there on that line. See? Like, that's pretty dang good. That's pretty dang good. How do I get rid of... Nope, that's... No! That's my article I just did. All right, hold on. Hold on. I'm so sorry. How did I do that? How did I just mess that up so badly? Oh my God. All right. Now, let's get it back. Let's get it back. All right, the worst video ever. I know. I'm sorry, everybody. Okay. We're going to clear this. There we go. And there's a splitter. Beautiful. We're back. We're back. All right, we have another lefty up. Normally what he's been doing now is fastballs away, right? I think we're going to see first pitch slider now, though. Oh, and he tried a first pitch curveball. Same idea. I want free real estate this time. I wanted a different approach this time of essentially just not the fastballs down, right? Because that's what we've been seeing so far. They talked to each other. They said, okay, cool. He's been starting lefties off with the fastball. Throw something else. He threw a curveball. He missed it. It's okay. Throw another one. Oh, that time he threw a fastball. And this, I mean, we don't have the box. But I'm telling you right now, not great. This is a little higher. Like, this would be normally, like level. This is a little high. I think he got away with one, especially 1-0, where Kyle Tucker's likely looking for heat at 1-0 in a pitch that he likes. I think he got away with that one a bit. With Gurriel, you can probably throw a slider for a strike here. Yeah, there you go. Oh, my God. Look at the jelly legs. The jelly legs, guys. Look at the legs. Ugh. He's just up. Nope. He's going for it. Nope. Never mind. Not for me. Not for me. You can really roll with this now. I think Gurriel is going to be sitting here for a fastball. Or he could be actually thinking of another slider here. So if you don't know which one to go with, honestly, I would throw a fastball up and in then. Because make it a tough one. If he doesn't want to swing on that, then it's going to be really hard for him. You could try and do a splitter in the dirt and really try and take advantage of him thinking that's a secondary pitch and jumping on it. We'll see. So he was leaning away. He was. What this generally tells me, when guys are backing up this much, I mean, that was inside. But when they're this late on getting out of the way, it generally means that they are looking down in a way, which means he was looking for the secondary pitch. So this 89 mile per hour, I'm going to call it the cutter. Honestly, there's some times that it's good that you threw a ball, because if it was a hittable one, they may have been ready for it. So that kind of felt like one of those there. At 1-1, yeah, you got to speed him up. You got to change his understanding of velocity at this point. So I would be throwing a fastball. Oh, man. And he threw a front door slider that had just enough movement to get back to the plate. Good on you, ump, because that is a strike. This is, if you can do this consistently, it's really tough to stay in and get that. But it can be dangerous if it's lower, because if a guy is expecting that slider, he's going to stay in and he's just going to hit that down the line. But that's insane. That's pretty crazy, especially up and in is like, you never see that with any consistency, or really also the ump giving that call, which we know he deserves, but still. So he hasn't seen heat this entire time. It looks like they're going to try and do a fastball up. You could really surprise him with a splitter down. We'll see. There's the 98 up and in. And I love this pitch. I'm a huge fan. And I know it's not a strikeout, but this is in the zone, and you get an out right away. You know? Instead of, like, you could have thrown a high heater. You could have thrown a heater, and that was a high one. But you could have thrown a heater up here instead. And maybe he doesn't swing. And all of a sudden now it's 2-2 and the count isn't over. I would much rather this one, which essentially plays the hand of Gurriel. Like, he could foul it off, fair. But he has to do something with this one. And this is a tough pitch to hit. I love it. I'm a fan of that. You know, the most effective pitch is one that gets an out. Whatever it is. Doesn't matter if it's a strikeout. Doesn't matter if it's an out in play. And yes, obviously that's kind of facetious in the way, like, well, you don't know that's always an out in play. I know. But there are some pitches that generally get them a lot more than others. And the best pitch, it doesn't matter what we wanted it to be, as long as it's an out. Like, that's great. So now we have a lefty again. And we saw him trying to do the curveball before. If I'm Ohtani, I'm saying I want to ensure that I have this. So I'm going to try the off-speed again. And he does. Oh, man. This ump is giving him everything on the slider on the arm side. I love it. I mean, it's never a strike. Poor Goodrum. That's never a strike. And honestly, I play with that again. I do it again. Because Umpy's giving me that. Oh, so he throws the cutter down. Oh, man. That's really filthy. Because remember before, what we're talking about here is generally with the danger zone is here, right? And you want to play with that. And this cutter goes from here down to there. And it kind of looks like it's going to land here, and it comes underneath it. And Goodrum is thinking, oh, this is a fastball after he did the first pitch slider. Nope. Not today. Sweet. Okay, so now 0-2, and you see that he's aggressive on that. You don't give him a hittable pitch. You give him something down, whether you want it to be the splitter or you want it to be the cutter or even the slider. Whatever it is, whatever you feel good with, you throw. Yeah, so you went with a splitter. Goodrum's like, aha, I got it. I figured it out. I knew you'd throw that off speed down because I just swung over one. Okay. I mean, that was also a very bad splitter. You throw it again. You gambit. Do the gambit. Don't give him a heater. Oh, my God. That is like, that is a swing of futility. And what I mean by that is it's never a strike. That pitch leaves Ohtani's hand and ends out of the zone, and then ends out of the zone. And Goodrum, after seeing the slider get called for a strike earlier in the count when it wasn't, means he has to swing at this one. Oh, man. And I will say, this is also the 87-mile-per-hour one, not the 84. So because of that, as we're talking about before with Yordan Alvarez not figuring out if it's the cutter or the slider, Goodrum might think this is coming back further to the plate. Right? Because he thinks it's a slider with a large horizontal movement. This one has tighter movement. So he thinks it's actually going to land around here and not have as much depth and more horizontal bend. But then it just stays away and dies. And Goodrum loses his helmet. Ooh! I mean, it's interesting, right? Like, you're not thinking about that. You see a guy, he swung at a ball that never became a strike. Like, what is he doing? That's why. It's all those little extra elements inside of the at-bat. I mean, Ohtani's feeling it. And, like, I love the fact he's doing this with, not really with fastballs. I mean, the good up and in with Gurriel was good. The good stuff to Kyle Tucker down. Oh, not to Kyle Tucker, but to Alvarez down in a way. Like, we've seen some good ones. But he's mostly just killing it with that slider. It's great. Here's Jason Castro. Free real estate coming? No, that's just 98 down the middle. And it's kind of interesting. Like, despite thinking, like, okay, I could be able to sneak one in now, right? Like, no. You did, I guess. He's late. But this was almost a double down the line, right? No one's there. You don't give him another fastball. He was behind on it, but you don't give him another fastball. He just swung at that. He wants one. Yeah. You're trying to do that backdoor cutter. Nope, didn't work. Do it again. Yeah, there's the slider that time. That one's the more aggressive slider. And that's what Goodrum thought that last pitch was. But instead, it was a cutter that stayed farther away. That's beautiful. I mean, really, I mean, that's just, again, I just want to emphasize, he's trying to put this here, right? This is where he's trying to go with it. Sometimes it's landed here, that's fine, but it hasn't landed here, right? He's avoided all of this with sliders. It's just been around here. It's pretty great, guys. It's pretty great. What do we got? Oh, my God. That's a splitty. What? This is so good. I mean, it just dies on him. That's like it's lined up right here. He's trying to go like here with it. And it just goes, nope. I'm going to go that way instead. I mean, look at this. And no, that might have been the cutter instead. I could be reading that wrong. But nevertheless, that's like, that is, oh man, that's so filthy. That's so filthy. All right. So now we got bottom third, 27 pitches, by the way. It's two outs in the third with 27 pitches. Fastball? Oh no. He was aggressive for it. And nope, that's free real estate. Still free real estate when the swing and miss. He threw a slider first strike at 0-0. That's free real estate. You're going to get a strike. And another. Like DJ Khaled. I mean, that's not where you want to put it. And it's actually kind of interesting. Ohtani, you know, it's easier with a lefty to be able to hit the inside corner here, right? But against a righty, you got to get a little bit more of the plate because the entire time you're throwing a slider, especially, like, you don't want it to land here. Let's say you want to land it here. that's a strike all the way through it, right? From the release point all the way down, that's what's going on. So it's more tempting. It's like harder to get away with that. That's why you kind of see you see them generally land here, because you want it to actually be a temptation to fall off. It's harder to sneak them in deeper in counts because of that. Early in counts, fine. But later on, it can be, when they're more aggressive, harder to sneak that in. So now at 0-2, I would just extend it further out like we were just talking about. Oh, no. And the thing is, too, you can kind of see how Siri is aggressive with his bat. He's ready for the heat. Like, he's prepared for this. You know, he's checking it and realizing it's too far away. And that's a huge indication to me that, oh, no, that was the wrong pitch call. That was the wrong one. Sure, he would have swung maybe it was up, but then could have done something with it. No, if I had him with more off speed, I would have got him. So I would actually do more off speed. Yeah, there you go. He wants to swing. That's what the 0-2 pitch, I think, in my view, that would have worked in 0-2. But we didn't know if necessarily Siri was looking for this or that. He gave it away with that bat check. It's a gorgeous slider. Again, a strike all the way through until the end. Beautiful. I mean, Ohtani is so good. Oh, he's so good. I'm so happy. Like, the guy I have with this shirt is amazing. okay. All right. So now we're back up to the top of the lineup, right? Fourth inning. He's only thrown 31 pitches. That's insane. It's 10 an inning. Oh, my God. For 3 outs? Are you kidding? So you got to maybe change things, right? That's the whole idea is the second time through the lineup, things change. Let's see what he does. Just going back with the slider, and that one's a low one at 81. So that means a more exaggerated movement. See the lower velocity, you're going to think a little bit more exaggerated movement. And Pena is trying to be like, look, I'm going to be aggressive, and I'm going to get a fastball, and I'm going to take advantage of it. Nope. Just throw it again. Throw it again if he's swinging like that. Yeah. Oh, my God. I mean, it's just such a good feel today for Ohtani. You know, the slider has been a pitch that we know has amazing movement, but his command of it is insane. We have not seen a slider get hung. We haven't seen it. I mean, there was one over here, and there was like one over here, but we have not seen like, hey, I'm a slider and like go and crush me yet. You know, it's pretty awesome. Let's get rid of that. So now throw it again. Throw it a third time. Okay, that was overthrown. Throw it a fourth time. Throw it a fourth time. Yes! Oh, yes! Guys, don't do this enough. Guy, okay, look. This at bat was one slider, swing and miss. Two slider, swing and miss. And so three, you're going to say third time. Yes, let's throw it again. It's out of the zone. So a lot of guys here would say, yeah, let's throw a fastball now. Oh, right, okay, so he's off of it now. I can't do that because I've thrown too many of them. Some would go back to a heater now and think, okay, I need to do this because he's figured me out. No. Throw another slider, and what do you know? He swings and misses. Gambit, okay? I think pitchers give hitters too much credit. Gambit, trust your stuff. Ugh, love it, Ohtani. First pitch, curveball, you know what that is? That's free real estate. And we saw him trying to do it before and missed it. Back to a lefty again, got the outside corner this time. Beautiful. Great. That felt like he's trying to do a splitter. I mean, that went that way. But that looked like more like a change grip or like a movement on. That was the strangest pitch I've seen so far. I think that's just a splitter that just came out wrong. But now, I mean, that's what he's trying to do. He's trying to showcase, like, I don't want to give Brantley a fastball. So I'd say it's probably a slider. It is that splitter again, 88. Okay. And I would say, oh, this is a tough pitch call here. Maybe a backdoor slider, but honestly, I would try and go fastball up. Keep him off balance. Oh, splitter again. Oh, my God. Is that cutter? I don't know. I can't tell from this angle. I feel like that's a splitter. I can't tell. I mean, that's just nasty, though. I mean, that's playing with the outside corner. He thinks it's going to land here, and it doesn't. Beautiful. I mean, again, Ohtani isn't making mistakes. He's not making mistakes here, especially deeper in counts. He's staying around the edges effectively. He's neck bearding. Okay? It's what you want to see. First pitch strike, free real estate. Now, if Bregman is smart and he anticipates a breaking ball, because you see how many breaking balls with Ohtani has thrown, keep in mind, first pitch fastball, the first at bat for Bregman, and that was an out. Now he goes to a breaking ball. This is actually pretty easy to hit, but you can only get away with this as a surprise at 0-0. Free real estate, okay? But if he's really in on this, this is a pretty meaty one that will follow the plane of the bat. Like the slider will meet the bat perfectly for a long time in the swing path. So that was a dangerous one. But free real estate, Bregman wasn't looking for it. He's not looking for it. I kind of want to surprise him with a fastball. I think he's going to be in his head as go. He's just throwing me breaking balls now. Yeah, so he was able to take that one. Yep. Gets him again with that slider, and that's just such a hard pitch to hit. I mean, it's really, you have to be so disciplined and follow it, and there's so much movement. I mean, again, you got to gambit. Like, as a hitter, it's not about, like, I think we make an assumption a lot that as the ball comes in, batters are just seeing it and reading where it's going to go and then swinging. It's not the case. It's the batter often will see the spin of the ball, essentially, and recognize what it is. And then say, okay, this pitch generally goes towards this area. And like, oh, it's a slider, so I need to overswing this way more than I would think because it just moves so much. You know? You have to, like, essentially go against your instincts of what it looks like. And, oh, that's a curveball. It looks like it's only going to go this far, but, like, I'm going to swing underneath how far it looks because it drops farther than it looks, right? It's hard. It's hard to do. But that's, I mean, I feel like Ohtani's kind of gone away with two sliders a little bit in this one, but he's worked it well against Bregman. Bregman's just getting the wrong reads. Now, 1-2. What do you go with? He hasn't elected to swing at the slider yet. And Bregman could be sold on that heater, but yeah, throw a slider away. It's been so good for you. Oh, he went with a splitter. Man. That looks so far away, but Bregman is thinking like, okay, he's throwing these sliders. I'm waiting for my heater. I'm going to get one. And, oh, God. Ohtani, sub 30% fastball usage in this. It works. It works. And you can't do that every time because guys will just realize that, oh, I'm just going to be looking for the breaking stuff. And so you have to have a mix of this, right? Like some days it's going to be 40%. Some days it's going to be 20. Like you got to go back and forth and, you know, change the day and change the lineup even in game. But it's so cool to see him succeed without it. Showcase like, no, I can do this on a given night. Because now guys are not going to think of one game plan just for Ohtani. That's really, really cool. He's trying to do the backdoor slider and misses it. See if he can do it again. Oh, he sneaks in a fastball. Shh. Don't swing. Don't swing, Alvarez. I'm trying to do another breaking ball. Nope. Gets a fastball in there. You'll love to see it. Okay. Sorry, I couldn't even say the thing I wanted to say. I think Alvarez was hoping for a fastball, but obviously was guessing that this would be a slider. He thinks it's coming farther in. He thinks this is the big slider and it's a shorter one with the cutter. Interesting. So he was expecting a 1-1 breaking ball there. So at 2-1, you might be able to sneak in a fastball. Yeah, you did. 98. Good job. So 2-1. The convention these days, the modern one that I emphasize a lot, is like, hey, throw a breaking ball in this. But because Ohtani's completely like leaning the other way, the sneaky pitch is actually a fastball, as Jordan has been anticipating more sliders. Pretty cool. Can you get him with another splitter now? Oh, he's too disciplined for that, right? Oh, there's a slider that Alvarez took a huge hack. Because this is coming across the plate. He knows it. And he missed it. It's a hard hit pitch to hit. I get you. I get it. Let's see. Yeah, he tries to go with the splitter. Yordan's ready for that because he's not expecting heaters right now. It's not bad. He's like, no, this is all the secondary at bat. Fastball? Yeah, so fastball that he tugged. He got away with this a little. I mean, this is actually, I take that back. This is really good. It's ball four. If Alvarez is truly looking secondary pitches his entire at bat, then I think he takes this. He might have been switching back to saying, no, it's full count. He's going to throw a fastball. And then Perfecto stays alive. Whew. That was a close one, man. That was a tough one. Yeah, it could have gone either way there. He tries to get free real estate, does not get it. There is a beautiful one coming back. I mean, really, that pitch has just been working so much for Ohtani. It's insane. And there's a fastball up and in, and I love that. I don't know if that's essentially where the intention was. Yeah, it does look like that, actually. Yeah, this is great. This is really, really, this is where you want to go. You want to go down away, up and in. This is beautiful. Like, you get a foul ball, you get a strike. 1-2, do you throw the splitter off of that? That'd be cool. No, it looks like they actually tried to do that, and he failed. It's all right. You're going to fail sometimes. That's okay. 2-2, do you throw a backdoor slider now? That'd be sweet. Oh, he threw the splitter that didn't go deep. He's not trying to get that as a called strike. He's trying to get that as a whiff down here. Tucker recognizes what it is and hopes it falls off, and it doesn't. Just enough. All right. We're still going here. 55 pitches in the fifth. Slider? Yep. He's trying to get some free real estate there. Slider again? Yep. Man, it's so good. You're not getting the heaters you want, Gurriel. Oh, my God. He totally cheated on that one, slider. That's three straight sliders. You probably can throw a fastball up now or a splitter, but it's probably going to be another slider. That was the splitter, and he didn't get that one down. We've actually seen a couple of these now that have floated up arm side and not quite gone the same depth as we want to see. But he's way ahead. He's still way ahead, so he threw another slider. Yes, he did. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. He's cheating so much for a heater. It's insane. I mean, how do you swing at this? Because this looks like a fastball coming up right now. This looks like a fastball that's going to go right about here. That's what it looks like, okay? And this pitch instead goes from here and just falls down. And that's how you swing at a pitch like this. Goes away, and he's like, oh, no. Yeah. Yeah, sorry, Gurriel. Not today, buddy. Not today. So there, oh wow, look at this. So this is a first pitch breaking ball again to a lefty. And Nico to try and break up the perfect game bunts. Look, a lot of people are going to say a lot of things about you do not bunt in a perfect game. Why? Why should anyone change their ability to try and win at this game because you are doing something? I don't care. I don't care about that whatsoever. I mean, hey, you gotta do it right. Look, they're shifting against you. Like, why should you take a disadvantage and not be allowed to bunt? No. Good job, Nico Goodrum. Sorry you didn't get it down, though, buddy. Close. Now that you got that established, probably throw another curveball. That was good enough. Oh, he throws that slider, swings over it. It's too nasty. Throw another one. I threw the splitter. Okay, fair enough. You can throw a fastball? Fastball would have worked, I think. You probably have him like completely messed up, and you have no idea. He has no reference point for the heater at this point. Yeah, it's like he wasn't. There was no way he was swinging at that pitch. He was so late in reacting to it. Now he threw the splitter. Oh, curveball! I think that was a curveball. Man, once again, Nico Goodrum swings at a ball outside for strike three. That's kind of cool. All right, we have one out here in the sixth. First pitch breaking ball. Yeah, he tries to do the curveball thing again. Maybe now he pepper a fastball away. Oh, man, the slider again. The guys just keep swinging at that. It's so filthy. Now he misses the fastball. I mean, Ohtani hasn't thrown the fastball a lot, so it makes sense. No? Oh, no. 3-1. Now, here's the thing. 3-1, if I'm Castro, what are you sitting for? You're sitting for a fastball right now. Oh, my God. That's so good. Like, if you want one pitch that represents the entirety of this start, it's that one. That's a 3-1 slider that is as perfect of a cold strike as you can get. You can't hit that. And any sort of advantage that Jason Castro had in this at-bat is instantly gone. There's no way Castro swings at this. There's no way. It's 3-1. This could be called as ball four. It wasn't, and it shouldn't. That's insanity. Oh my God. You throw it again. Yeah. Oh no! No! Oh man. I mean, here's the thing. He just threw it so perfectly and it went too far over. You know? Like, this is supposed to be, we want this over here, and it falls off too far that way, and Castro expecting a secondary pitch of some kind because he just threw the best 3-2, 3-1 secondary pitch. You're expecting that to, that's just coming too close to the barrel. It's going into the bat. It's easy for Castro to do that. Ah, that stinks. There goes a perfecto. All right, well, he's still in there. He's got a game to finish here for six innings. There's a first pitch breaker for an out. You love to see it. And let's see here. All right, first pitch slider. Didn't get it with Pena. Remember, Pena swung at miss all four of them last time. And there you go. Sneaks into fastball because Pena hasn't seen a single fastball at all this game from Ohtani. And they're back to the slider. He just swung and missed on it, hoping to get another. Like, what do you do? You throw another slider. Yeah. He thinks he earned it. You throw another slider. You throw another slider, 2-2. Oh, fastball. I think he did check it. No? He didn't check it? 3-2. I mean, throw a slider. He can't hit your slider. There it is. Oh, he fouls it off. Good on Pena for fouling that off. It does kind of say that Pena wasn't looking for a slider, because if he was, that would have been hit, I think. I think that was more of an adjustment to not a fastball, but it's in the zone. It's easy enough to hit. It's in the close enough to the plate that he could put some contact on that. So maybe a splitter would be sick. Oh, and he walked him, tugged him. And this is kind of, he's getting up to 80 pitches now. And the fastball is okay, there you go. First pitch, curveball, you got out of it. And I believe that is Ohtani's start, yes. Man, so Ohtani, you're dope. You make us feel dope. I wish I had a final shot of you because I just want you to understand, here you are, buddy, how good you are. I will say one of the major takeaways of this is the best I've ever seen Ohtani slider. Like, the best I've ever seen it. It was insane. You guys saw it too. So, so incredible. I don't know if that's going to stick. I hope it does. The fastball had its moments, but when he needed it most, he walked him. He tugged it. And that is still going to be something that plagues Ohtani a little bit, I think, is that heater. But man, we saw the amazing slider. We saw essentially a cutter version of it too. Splitters were 60% consistent, maybe 50%. Some amazing strikeouts early on, kind of floated a little bit up arm side, but really that slider is one of the best in the game if it's like that all the time, right? Oh, that was such a fun start. And I hope we see more of that from Shohei Ohtani. But right, this video has been long enough. Thank you so much for being around. As always, you can watch me on Twitch at 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. every single weekday morning. Come on by, ask all the questions that you have. Thanks for being here. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, please leave a like. And of course, hit the subscribe and the bell and all that fun stuff. Helps me out a ton. You don't want to miss any of these. I'm doing these 5 days a week, guys. So come check them out and learn about all these pitchers. But yeah, Ohtani is the best. And that was super fun. But that's going to do it for today. So my name is Nick Pollack. And may your BABIPs be low and your strikeouts high.